So for this build, you're going to want to use this fourth pie chart right here, where you have defense and rebounding and finishing as your primary attributes. For the physical profile, you're going to want to go with this second one here, because obviously you want 95 strength. And out of the ones with 95 strength, you can see that this one does have the highest vertical, which is what you're going to need for rebounding. Once you do get to your attributes, you're going to want to max out your close shot for sure, max out your standing dunk, and then max out your post hook. We'll get back to these two later. You want to max your pass accuracy, or at least put it to 60 or 65, but I'm going to max it. You're going to want to max out your post moves. And when it comes to defense, you want to max out your interior defense and max out your block and your rebounding. So you're going to have 64 attributes left. If you do play Pro-Am, you're going to want to upgrade your free throw, but for now, I'm just going to make this build for the park. So your post fade, you can upgrade it if you want. Honestly, this all has to do with your playstyle. I'm going to upgrade it here because it gives you a lot more versatility on offense if you have an 80 post hook as well as a 75 post fade. Driving dunk and standing layup are difficult because right now you can see they're at 49 and 51, but once I do raise the height for this build, these are going to drop a lot. So even if I do upgrade them, they're going to be really low. So for now, I'm just going to leave those alone, and same with the shooting. The shooting is not great at all, so it's not worth it to move the 33 three-pointer up to a 48. I'm just going to leave that at a 33 since you're not going to be taking three-pointers on this build. Also, I did not touch this defense down here because these three categories are mainly for guards. And since this build is going to be in the paint most of the time, you're not really going to be in the passing lane, so you're not going to get many steals, even if your steal is upgraded. So I'm going to spend the last attribute points on driving layup and driving dunk. They're going to drop, but it's better to have them in the 60s or in the 50s than in the 40s. So like I said, once you do raise the height, the driving layup and driving dunk are going to drop, but they are in the 50s instead of the 40s. The passing accuracy does drop a lot. That's why I maxed it out. And the defense goes down. The three categories I didn't upgrade, they're gonna go down. The block does go up, and the interior defense does go up. So when it comes to the weight of this build, you're gonna wanna max it out so you can be an absolute force inside the paint, and that's also gonna max your defense. And with the wingspan, you're also gonna wanna put that all the way up because your block is gonna go way up. Post moves will go down a little bit, but barely any, and same with your shooting, but you're not gonna be taking jump shots on this player anyway. So when it comes to takeover, of course you're gonna wanna go rim protector takeover. It's so much better than glass cleaner takeover, and you can be a beast inside the paint on offense and on defense. As you can see, this build right here is a paint beast because it's a beast in the paint on offense as well as defense. So when it comes to badges, with the finishing badges, you're gonna wanna put down back down punisher for sure. Drop stepper hall of fame. You can put deep hooks on hall of fame if you want because you do have an 80 post hook, but that's not really my type of play style, so I'm not gonna equip that badge on my player. I am gonna put relentless finisher to hall of fame. That is one of the best badges in the game in my opinion. And you're not really gonna be taking acrobatic layups, so you don't need acrobat or cross key score. So I'm gonna spend the rest of the points on contact finisher. Then I'm gonna put back boss to silver, and I'm gonna put pick and roller to gold. For shooting badges, since your shooting stats are really low, you can go with deep fades because your fade is actually decent at a 75. You can go with hot start, so if you make your first shot, all the shots after it will be boosted until you do miss. You can also go with hot zone hunter because most of your shots will be taken in the paint, so it'll boost the shots from there. Or you can go with volume shooter if you're going to be one of the main scorers on your team, but personally, I'm going to go with hot zone hunter. When it comes to playmaking, you're pretty limited on your badges. Since my passing accuracy is low, I'm going to put break starter to gold, so that'll help me with that. You're also going to want to put unpluckable on gold so you don't get ripped as much. Post spin technician on gold. And then with this last bronze badge, you can honestly put whatever you want. I think the most useful for this build will be dream shake. Or you could honestly put it to bailout if you want, if you're going to take a shot and then pass out of it. And last but not least, we got the best part of this all, the defense. So with these badges, the first one I'm going to upgrade for sure is Rebound Chaser. That's basically like Hustle Rebounder and Rim Protector to Hall of Fame. Those two badges together are going to be amazing. And there are also two more rebounding badges. There's Box, which helps you box out, and Worm, which helps you break out of box outs. I'm going to leave that alone. You could put Defensive Leader on Hall of Fame. It's kind of like Dimer, where it gives your teammates a boost, but it's on defense instead of on jump shots. Clamps, you could put to Hall of Fame also, but since you are a big man, you're going to be in the paint most of the time. But I'm going to put it to Silver just in case there are some stretch bigs that you're going to be guarding. The thing is, with these badges, a lot of these are for guards, so a lot of them I don't have to worry about, like Interceptor. I didn't really upgrade my steel, so I don't need that. Same with Pick Dodger and Pickpocket. But I am going to put Intimidator on gold, and as you can see, I just put Brick Wall on Hall of Fame. Honestly, if you want to, you can lower these from Hall of Fame and lower them from gold to silver if you want to have more badges. But I think it's better to just have a bunch of badges Hall of Fame instead of having all these here bronze, because some of them honestly don't matter too much. So those are going to be the badges I'm going with. I'm going to go into the post right now, try to body Willie Cauley-Stein since I do have Hall of Fame drop stepper and back down punisher. As you can see, I'm just bodying him. So with this build in the post, pretty much all you want to do is drop step for the main part because of back down finisher and drop stepper Hall of Fame. You can do fades and hooks, like I said before. It makes your game a little bit more versatile. But if you want on this build, you can lower your hook and fade and just drop step only. And then you could upgrade your defense and other stuff. But I wanted to make this build a little bit more versatile. So right now I'm going to go back into the post. Let's see if I can body D'Angelo Russell. He is a guard, so he's going to be easy to guard. As you can see, this build already amazing. Back on offense, I'm going to use post spin technician to get right past Willie Cauley-Stein, take a layup on Draymond, who's a lockdown, and still manage to green it. I was 34% covered, and he was kind of in my face too. That's the thing about this build. So in NBA 2K19, you guys probably know that the height difference was crazy. If you did have a smaller big man... Bro, I really took that shot and it was only 11% covered. This build is crazy. So you guys probably know that in NBA 2K19, the height difference was insane. If there was a 7-foot post scorer going up against a 7'3", the 7'3 post scorer bodied the 7-foot post scorer pretty much all the time. And apparently in NBA 2K20, that height difference is even crazier. It's going to be even more of a mismatch, which makes taller players even better. So right here, I'm going to go into the post one more time. I'm going to actually take a fade this time, and that fade animation is trash. I still managed to make that with a horrible release. I don't know why that animation was so bad. But as you can see, we are shooting 86%, which is amazing. Right here on the fast break, I'm going to try to get Fred to give me the ball. There we go. We got the ball. I'm just going to body Willie Cauley-Stein once again. Look at this. Back down punisher and then drop stepper right there. Easy. Easy money. This build is so good. I can get such good animations every single time. And once I do get takeover, you're going to see how overpowered that is too. Okay, so Steph Curry does end up missing that shot right there. As you can see, Hall of Fame rebound chaser. Right here, I'm going to activate takeover. I do have rim protector takeover. I'm going to try to bait Willie Cauley-Stein into taking bad shots. Right here, as you can see, I'm taking a shot on two people, 7% covered. Because this build is super tall, and the finishing ability with standing layups and standing dunks is crazy. So Willie Cauley-Stein, I'm trying to bait him right now. He is sitting on the three, so he's probably not going to get the ball. Right here, back into the post. We got Kevon Looney on us, a good defender, and we're still going to get right past him. This build is good against bad defenders, against good defenders. Right here, we are guarding Alphonso McKinney. Why is he at center? I have no idea, but I'm going to try to get them to pass him the ball. They are not passing right now. I can't even show you guys the takeover. There we go. Now we're on him. No way he's making that shot with rim protector takeover. He's going to shoot again, and oh, he's there. There we go. No way that goes in. Yeah, he's not making anything with rim protector takeover. That one he might make, yeah. Ibaka kind of got on him there, so I could not get the contest. But anyway, you guys get the point. Rim protector takeover, probably one of the best takeovers, if not the best takeover in the game. And this build is crazy even without takeover. Okay, defense right here. See, you can just bait your guy into blocks. So easy. Once they get the ball, they just shoot it. Easy block every time. Okay, going back into the paint. Hopefully I don't get double teamed again. Post up. Oh, I'm getting double teamed. Yeah, they are double teaming. That's not good. Okay, I'm going in the post. I'm not passing out. If I could hold the ball, that'd be nice. Drop step, easy money. Bro, he's getting shoved out of the way. He's a good defender too. The thing is, he's just a shorter defender. So this build can bully power forwards. Oh my gosh, bro, I didn't even block that and he missed. I thought, oh my gosh, I thought I wasn't even gonna get that block. Right here, you can see Marcus Gasol's locking up too. Everyone's locking up. Right here, he did end up greening the shot. I couldn't get in front of him in time. Okay, back on defense. Can we get Draymond? Oh, I was trying to bait him, but he didn't cut. And oh my gosh, I'm gonna smack that. Yo, can I finish on the break? Can I finish on the break? Keep running, keep running, keep running. Euro, Euro, Euro. Best Draymond. Oh, I missed. Okay, I got the rebound. Oh, I tried to fake. Just gonna body this man, take a fade. Oh my gosh, bro. I'm greening, but these animations are kind of bad. Right here, I'm just gonna drop step. Easy money, bro. Easy money. I get a good drop step animation almost every time. Oh, pass to him, pass to him, pass to him. There we go. Oh, that was not a block, but he did miss the shot. See, this build is crazy. Every time I get a contest, it's a miss. Okay, here we are back in the post. D'Lo's trying to double, but I'm going to post spin and get an easy dunk past Willie Cauley-Stein and on to Draymond. Oh my gosh, look at that snag. Yo, he went for a putback. I got the snag somehow. Hustle rebounder or whatever the new rebounding badge is called. It's good. Okay, just going to go past Curry easily. Okay, post spin. Post up, drop step, easy money. Oh my gosh, it's too easy, bro. 4 seconds, this man's trying to dribble, get into the paint. No way, get out. I don't even got a jump to block him. I'm trying to get people to get baited to going into the paint. Oh, he's going to take that shot, and he's going to miss, and I'm going to snag over two people. Let's go. Okay, I'm running the break. I'm going to post up before somebody tries to double me. And there's the double team. Okay, give me the ball back. Back into the paint. Drop step. Easy layup. Easy layup. Easy layup. Oh my. Bro. I jumped at the perfect time, but this man took forever to block the ball. That was a goaltend. Now my takeover went down even more. Oh, why do I got D'Lo on me? Okay, I'll take it. Let me take that. Let me take that shot. Easy, like Shaq. So let me just do a quick drop step. Easy money. Let's go. Oh my gosh, he's going to miss that with his takeover. Okay, let's run into the paint. Come on, move Curry. I can't run. Oh, he's throwing a lob to Siakam. Okay. Okay, back into the post. I am cold and I have Oh no. Oh no. Oh no, this man can't hold me. Anyway, what I was saying, I have Gatorade and I'm cold. The one thing about the demo that's bad is that you get tired so fast that at the very end of the game, it's so hard to make shots. As you can see, after that and one and making the free throw, I'm still cold. This is not looking too good. Okay, let's see. Can Curry not hit a three? No. No. Okay, thank goodness, bro. Curry almost hit a three because this man Lowry left him open, but we are going to win the game. I did finish with 41 points, 10 rebounds, and 4 blocks, as you can see. My field goal percentage did get a lot worse towards the end because of the Gatorade symbol, and it was really hard to make shots while I was tired. But as you can see in the top right, there's a block highlight. I was getting rebounds that it looked like I shouldn't have gotten, but I am 7'3". I do have a pretty decent vertical for my height because of the athleticism. This build can do it all inside. Outside, not too much, but being able to hit fadeaways, it's gonna be so good once you're able to change your animations when the actual game comes out. And also with this build, if you want, you can choose the very top pie chart if you wanna not focus on defense at all. If you want this build to be an offensive beast, you can do pretty much everything that I did, but don't worry about the defense as much and just worry about the inside game and inside badges and all that. But I think this build is a better all-around build because the inside scoring drops a tiny bit and the defense goes up a lot. I am going to be looking into more builds to also find other good big man builds. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like, subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's been King Josh and I'm out. Peace.